students, how are you all? I hope that you all are fine, fit, healthy at your home. I'm Gayathri, your new science teacher. Welcome you all again to the science online videos. Students, as you know that we are going to begin our session with the thought. So what is the thought of the day? The first rule of focus is wherever you are, be there. I repeat my thought. The first rule of focus is wherever you are, be there. Students, it means that if you need to be concentrated when you are studying or when you are doing any task, at that time you need to be more concentrated. But for this concentration, you require to be at the same time wherever you are. जहाँ पर आपको बस उसी के बारे में you have to think, okay? Then you will be really be focused, okay? So students, let us start our today's session. So are you all ready? Yes? Okay. So before starting our today's session, let us do quick recapitulation of it. Okay, so first we will do quick recapitulation. So students, what we have covered? Good conductors, the substances which allow heat energy to flow are called good conductors. You are very well aware good conductors क्या होते हैं? Conductors वो होते हैं जो heat energy को क्या करते हैं? Flow करने के लिए allow करते हैं. Okay? So the substances which allow heat energy to flow are called good conductors. Okay? Bad conductors, the substances which do not allow the heat energy, main is to learn to do not allow the heat energy to flow are called bad conductors. So good conductors or bad conductors, if I am going to tell you what is the difference between these two, so you should be remembered that once the heat energy is able to flow, that is called good conductors. But when we do not allow them to flow through the material, so they are known as bad conductors. Is that clear? Okay. For bad conductors, we have another name that is called insulators. That is called insulators. Okay. Students, as you can see, I have written key term on a board. So let us read it. Insulator. Insulator, a material through which very little or no heat flows, as its statement tells us that we are talking about the material through which a little, very little or no heat can flow, it are called insulators. So bachche, insulators kya hote hain? Wo material jisse ya to heat bahut thoda ya bilkul nahi pass karta, that is called your insulators. So today we are also going to deal with the its practical applications. Practical applications. So we are going to deal with practical applications. When I am saying you the practical applications, it means all the things are reason based. So let us start with this also. So students, next topic for today's session is practical applications of heat insulators. I have already told you about this, that in this we are going to get the statements and you have to find out its reason. Okay, so just move to your science book on page number A41. You can see it is written over here 4.8, practical applications of heat insulators. Okay, so let us read from the book, then we will move towards the board. Bad conductors help in conserving energy in a system. When you are reading this statement that it helps in conserving energy, it means that when there is no heat flowing takes place, or when a very little amount of heat flows, it means directly or indirectly it is conserving energy. Right, students? Okay. Next, glass wool, wool, cotton, slack wool, asbestos, and closed air vacuum, etc. are the common insulating material. These are certain insulating materials given in your book, that wool hai, jaise wool hai hamare paas, cotton hai, asbestos, what they do? They just enclosed vacuum and they do not allow the heat to flow it. Is that clear? Now you can see from your book first paragraph, We wear woolen clothes in winter because. Okay, just have a look on the board. We wear woolen clothes in winter. ठीक है, सर्दी में हम सब लोग woolen clothes पहनते हैं, सभी को पता है why, reason. Because woolen yarn contain a large amount of trapped air. Very simple. But usually we used to wear in winter season. Woolen clothes, sweaters पहनते हैं आप लोग. When you wear the sweater, at that time what happened? A large amount of thread, a large amount of air in the threads of your sweater get trapped. Clear? Means जो आप sweater पहनते हो, woolen जो yarns होते हैं, जो threads होते हैं, they contain a large amount of trapped air. जो air होता है, उसको काफी हद तक वो क्या करता है? Trap कर लेता है. ठीक है? That's why during winter season we feel warm. Is that clear? Now read from the book also. So let us read from the book. We wear woolen clothes in winter because woolen yarn contains a large amount of trapped air. Since you know that air is a bad conductor of heat, very true. So it does not allow the body to flow the heat outward as our bodies stop losing heat and we feel warm. Is that clear, bachcho? What happened? It is going to, as you know that air is a bad conductor of heat, so woolen yarn, woolen threads of your sweater just trap the air inside it, does not allow the air to flow outward. So that's why we feel warm. Samajh mein aa gaya? Next. Two woolen blankets are warmer than thick वूलन ब्लैंकेट. मैं कहती हूँ दो वूलन ब्लैंकेट आपको मैं दे दूं और मैं आपको कहूं कि एक वूलन ब्लैंकेट से ज्यादा कंपैरेटिवली ज्यादा गर्म है. व्हाई? व्हिच इज द रीजन? बिकॉज ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा लेयर ऑफ एयर ट्रैप बिटवीन थिन ब्लैंकेट. वी नो दैट टू ब्लैंकेट इज हैविंग अ थिन ब्लैंकेट, सो इन दिस थिन ब्लैंकेट द एयर इज ट्रैप्ड. इज दैट क्लियर? Now look on page number 841, second point, everyone. Two thin woolen blankets are warmer than a thick woolen blanket because there is an extra layer of air trapped between thin blankets and this act as an insulator which does not allow the heat to escape from the body to flow out. Is that clear? सेकेंड क्लियर हो गया? सेकेंड पॉइंट सभी बच्चों को? यस? ओके, नाउ वी विल डू थर्ड पॉइंट. थर्ड पॉइंट, वी वियर शर्ट स्वेटर कोट एटसेट्रा रादर देन वन थिक गार्मेंट बिकॉज. स्टूडेंट्स लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हियर. इन विंटर सीजन व्हाट यूजुअली वी डू? वी वियर जैकेट्स कोट स्वेटर शर्ट. ओके, rather than one thick garment. इसके पीछे रीजन क्या है? बिकॉज एक्स्ट्रा लेयर्स ऑफ एयर ट्रैप्ड बिटवीन एवरी टू गार्मेंट्स मीन्स द टू गार्मेंट्स लाइक यू आर वेयरिंग शर्ट एंड स्वेटर सो इट इज कंपोज ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा लेयर्स ऑफ एयर मीन्स इट इज हैविंग अ थिन लेयरिंग सो इट विल ट्रैप मोर हीट एंड दिस एक्स्ट्रा लेयर ऑफ एयर ट्रैप्ड बिटवीन टू गार्मेंट्स. इज दैट क्लियर? Now read from book. It is now for the same reason that we wear number of garments in winter, such as undershirt, shirt, sweater, coat, rather than one thick garment, because extra layers of air which are trapped between every two garments, they act as an insulators. They act as an insulators. Very good. Now fourth. बर्ड्स, आपने देखा होगा विंटर में जो बर्ड्स होती है, दे जस्ट पफ अप देयर फेदर्स. दे जस्ट पफ अप देयर फेदर्स. व्हाट इज द रीजन बिहाइंड इट? बिकॉज दे ट्रैप अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ एयर. क्योंकि वो क्या करते हैं, अपनी फेदर्स में बहुत सारा एयर को क्या कर चुके होते हैं, ट्रैप कर चुके होते हैं एंड दिस एक्ट एज एन इंसुलेटर. एंड ड्यूरिंग विंटर सीजन व्हेन दे पफ अप देयर फेदर्स दे ट्रैप लॉट ऑफ एयर एंड This is how the feathers act as an insulator, and this makes them feel fog. Clear okay bachcho? Next we will do fifth point. So students, what you have to remember here, that when we are talking about the insulators, okay, so here we are talking about that air is getting trapped but it is not escaping out. Okay, next is Eskimos make igloos out of snow. Because you have seen that jo Eskimos hote hain wo apne igloos banate hain, iske piche reason kya hai? Snow contain a fairly large amount of trapped air which act as an insulator. What does snow do? Snow contain a large amount of air, and due to which it acts as an insulator, due to which jo Eskimos hote hain they feel it warm when they just live inside the igloo. This is the reason behind it. Is that clear, students? Now we will read from the book. Eskimos make igloo out of snow. You can underline this line, because snow contain a fairly large amount of trapped air which act as an insulator. Thus, the heat generated within the igloo does not flow out. Hence, it keeps us warm. Keeps them warm. Okay, means जो स्नो होता है ट्रैप इन लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ एयर एंड द स्नो डज नॉट अलाउ देम द हीट टू कम आउट. तो हीट बाहर वापस आता नहीं, इससे क्या होता है वो जो इग्लू में रहते हैं दे फील इट फॉर्म. क्लियर? सिक्स पॉइंट, एनिमल्स इन कोल्ड कंट्रीज आर जनरली कवर्ड विद थिक फर. स्टूडेंट्स यू हैव ऑल्सो हर्ड अबाउट द पोलर बियर्स पेंगुइन्स. ठीक है, जो जितने भी हमारे जो कोल्ड कंट्रीज है जहां पे एनिमल्स होते हैं, देखो वो देयर बॉडी आर जनरली कवर्ड विद थिक फर, राइट? उनकी बॉडी पे क्या होता है, बॉडी इज कवर्ड विद फर. नाउ व्हाट द फंक्शन ऑफ द फर ट्रैप्स अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ एयर. जो उनके फर्स होते हैं दे आर जस्ट गोइंग टू ट्रैप अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ एयर. वंस दे आर ट्रैपिंग अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ एयर द फर एक्ट एज एन इंसुलेटर. दिस इज हाउ द ऑल द एनिमल्स which lives in cold countries feel warm. Clear? उनके जो furs होते हैं उनमें क्या होता है, उसमें बहुत बहुत सारा air जो होता है trap हो जाता है, और वो furs उनके लिए insulators का काम करते हैं. Is that clear? Yes? Okay students. Seventh point. Mud houses, जो कच्चे घर होते हैं आपने देखा होगा, जो मिट्टी के बने हुए होते हैं और घास फूस की उनकी जो छत होती है उसकी बात कर रहे हैं यहाँ पर. Mud houses with thatched roof keeps cool in summer, ठंडी गर्मी में एकदम ठंडा रहेगा, and warm in winter, और सर्दी में गर्म. Because reason, because thatched roof contain a large amount of trapped air. क्योंकि जो thatched roof होता है contains large amount of air. Is that clear? Now we will read both the points from the book also. Animals in the cold countries are generally covered with thick fur. Sixth point dekhenge sabhi. The fur traps a large amount of air and act as an insulator. Thus, the heat generated within them does not allow them to come out. This is how they feel warm. Okay. Seventh, mud houses with thatched roofs keeps cool in summer and warm in winter, as compared to concrete houses. Concrete houses मतलब होता है बच्चे जो पक्का घर होता है, जो सीमेंट वगैरह का बना हुआ होता है उसकी बात करें. Here we are doing the comparison between mud house and the concrete house. So what the thatched roof do? It contain large amount of air. Similarly, you know that mud is a bad conductor of heat. हमें पता है जो mud होता है वो क्या होता है, bad conductor होता है. So in summer, heat from outside does not flow in, and winter heat from inside does not flow out. देखो कितना अच्छा एक तरीके का प्रोसेस है. गर्मी में जो गर्म बाहर होता है वो उस थैश्ड रूफ के अंदर नहीं जा सकता, और सर्दी में जो उसके अंदर हीट होता है दे डज नॉट अलाउ देम टू स्केप आउट. सो दैट्स वाई द हाउस रिमेन cool in summer and warm in winter. Is that clear? Yes? Okay, now we will do some more points related to. Now you all are thinking that here ma'am is always talking that they are trapping the air, right? So students, no need to get confused, because once you will get all these statements, you have to just give the answer in context of the trapping of air. Why? Because here we are talking about the insulators, and we know that the material which does not allow or a very little heat to pass through it. So they are known as insulator. So when you get these type of statement in your exams, so you have to just write down in terms of the trapping of air. Is that clear? False ceiling is provided in rooms and the space in between is filled with asbestos or sawdust to keep the room cool. Students, you know that the ceiling fans are there in the room and they are all filled with sawdust, because we know that wood which is used in ceiling fan is a bad conductor of air. So the air trapped in sawdust is bad conductor. Now what you have to understand from the book, false ceiling is provided in rooms and the space in between is filled with asbestos so as to keep room cool. कि वैसे हमारे क्या होते हैं जो रूम्स होते हैं कैसे होते हैं ठंडे होते हैं. So reason क्या होगा, the wood used for false ceiling is a bad conductor of heat. The air trap, जो air trap होता है उसमें, that is a bad conductor and it does not allow them to flow out. That's why the room keeps cool. Is that clear? Okay, now we will do some more points. Students, look at 9 point. Appliances like electric kettles, electric irons, electric ovens, soldering rods, cooking pans, etc. They all are provided with wooden or plastic handles. आपने सब देखा होगा, चाहे kettles की बात करें, oven की बात करें, या कुकिंग पैन्स. व्हेन योर मम्मा प्रिपेयर्ड द कुक्स द फूड इन द किचन, यू हैव सीन दैट द पैन्स आर प्रोवाइडेड विद हैंडल्स एंड दीज हैंडल्स आर ईदर मेड ऑफ द वुड और द प्लास्टिक, राइट? व्हाई? व्हाट इज द रीजन? बिकॉज दे आर बैड कंडक्टर्स ऑफ हीट. क्यों? क्योंकि ये क्या है, बैड कंडक्टर्स हैं हीट के एंड इट डज नॉट अलाउ फ्लो टू द हैंडल्स द हीट. जो उसके जैसे खाना बनाते हैं तो जो हीट होता है ड्यू टू कैंडल फ्लेम, वो जो वुड और आपका प्लास्टिक का बना हुआ हैंडल होता है, यू डोंट फील इट वॉर्म, यू डोंट फील इट हॉट, बिकॉज हीट डज नॉट फ्लो टू द हैंडल्स. विद द रिजल्ट वी कैन होल्ड देम वेरी इजली, इजंट इट? वंस यू आर जस्ट यूजिंग ऑल दीज अप्लायंसेस, जस्ट कीप दिस थिंग इन योर माइंड दैट यू आर यूजिंग the handles made of plastic or wood. So definitely it does not allow the heat flow to the handles. That's why it is very suitable for us to hold it. Is that clear? This is what I have written over here also. Appliances like electric kettles, electric irons, ovens, cooking pans are provided with wooden handles because they are bad conductors of heat. Students, here on the board I am writing in short so that you might be remember all these points. Okay, now we will do next points. 10th point. Slabs of ice are covered with sawdust or gunny bags to prevent them from melting. Why is it so? Because it contains large amount of trapped air. Now we will read from book. Slabs of ice are covered with sawdust or gunny bags to prevent them from melting. आपने देखा होगा जो आइस होते हैं, they are covered with a bag. And why is it so? In order to prevent them from melting. And how is it going to take place? The sawdust or gunny bags contain a large amount of trapped air which act as an insulator and it does not allow the heat from outside to reach the ice. Okay students, now we are left with 2 more points. After this topic will be over. 11th point. In cold countries, double glass window panes are used. Okay, students, here we are talking about the countries which are cold. यहाँ पे जो क्या होते हैं, जो windows होते हैं, they are just having a double glasses, so it leaves a small gap filled with air. Now what? Because the trapped air act as an insulator. जो trapped air होता है, वो कैसे act करता है? Insulator की तरह. And it does not allow the heat from the room to flow out. और जो heat room के अंदर होता है, it does not allow them to flow outside. Thus, room keeps warm. In short, the double glass window panes are used leaving the gap filled with air because the trapped air acts as an insulator. Okay, students. Now one more point. Steam pipes are covered with asbestos straws or glass blue to prevent heat losses due to conduction. Student, it means that steam pipes जो होती है आपकी, they are covered with glass blue. और उससे क्या करते हैं? They prevent heat loss. It does not allow the heat to flow out due to conduction. Okay? Now we will read from book also. Steam pipes are covered with asbestos straws or glass blue to prevent heat losses due to conduction. Okay, students. So this completes all the practical applications of heat insulators. I hope that you all have understood all the reasons related to the topic. Okay. So students, for today's homework, you have to revise all the topics. Okay. The topic which I have taken, like practical application of heat insulators, you have to go through it to the topics, to the points. You have to learn all the points. Then second thing, about the good conductors and bad conductors. This is your homework that you have to revise the class work which I have done today. Okay, students. So I hope that you all will learn. And when we will meet in next class, I am going to ask you. Okay. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.